Hey everyone, thanks for visiting us here at ArkleTechsHomepage.com. I'm meteorologist Josh Marses with your Saturday afternoon evening forecast update as we've enjoyed some quiet weather conditions to start out the weekend here. Very cold this morning, and that will be the case again tonight, but we did see most areas in the 50s this afternoon. We did have a few locations in the low 60s, including Shreveport today, and we are looking at a pretty nice temperature jump tomorrow, so a lot of us will be pushing 70 degrees on Sunday. Pretty quiet start to next week, but we're watching late next week for the potential maybe a few days of rainfall here, and I'll touch on that once we get to the 7-day forecast here in just a moment. But again, for today and tomorrow, you see high pressure just kind of sliding by the region. It's steering in the north wind today, which is a cool wind, which is why we saw those highs in the 50s and low 60s. And tomorrow we'll get the south wind returning on the backside of that area of high pressure. And of course, the south wind off the Gulf, always a warming wind for us. So that's what will push our high temperatures back into the upper 60s and low 70s. So at the moment, again, recording this at about 4 o'clock, we are in the 50s and should have a pretty quick temperature drop tonight. So eventually through the 40s this evening, and all locations forecast to drop into the 30s, and could have a little bit of freezing temperatures north of I-30 down to 31 in Ida Belle and DeQueen, and likely going to see that freeze right around sunrise tomorrow morning. So if you have early morning plans there, potentially could see a little frost in those locations. But again, high pressure scooting over tomorrow, and most of the day on Monday will keep us dry. And you can see on futurecast here, really the only change on the actual map will be the change in wind direction, starting out with the blue arrows there indicating the north wind, and as we head through the overnight, pretty much looking at calm winds, but by the time we get to tomorrow morning, should see that south wind start returning across the region. If you have outdoor plans tomorrow, especially on some of the waterways, why not, with the temperatures in the upper 60s and low 70s, kind of a steady southwest breeze at about 10 miles per hour expected to develop in the late morning and afternoon. But other than that, should see all day sunshine, maybe just a few upper level clouds drifting through, but nothing that will get in the way of any outdoor activities that you may have planned. And look at those high temperatures, not too bad, 70 in Marshall. A little bit cooler along I-30, but again, not by much. Mid-60s still going to feel fantastic in those locations. I have Shreveport up to 70 degrees tomorrow, as well as Natchitoches and across Oklahoma and Arkansas. Mid to upper 60s for us, so a nice little warm-up from where we were today. And should enjoy similar weather conditions on Monday, but our next cold front making its way in Monday night into Tuesday morning. Still looks like the potential we could see some lightly scattered rain Monday night into Tuesday morning, but we should clear out pretty quickly on Tuesday. And if we do see any accumulations here, likely going to be extremely light, so the rain not going to have much of an impact with this front. It will drop the temperatures for a few days. Tuesday, Wednesday will drop back into the 50s and low 60s, and late next week things could get interesting for us. As of right now, the GFS or the American model shows rain developing Thursday and much of the day Friday, as does the European model, so pretty confident in that Thursday and Friday forecast, and kind of low-end ingredients at this point to see some strong to severe storms. So at this point, nothing screaming that we'll see any kind of severe weather threat, but we'll need to monitor it because there will be some ingredients there that could potentially lead to some thunderstorms both of those days. And the European model keeps us rainy most of the day Saturday. Because of that, it is showing some 3 to 6 inch accumulations as far as rainfall, especially across the I-20 corridor Thursday through Saturday. The GFS or the American model, it's showing the rain clearing out pretty quickly early Saturday, which would give us a dry day Saturday and much lower rainfall totals, which it's showing in the 1 to 2 inch range with the heaviest rain across I-30. So a big discrepancy with the forecast models. I am confident in the Thursday, Friday being rain there, but the Saturday forecast kind of up in the air at this point. So if you have plans for next weekend, need to monitor things just as far as the next few days to have a little more clarity with the forecast as we head into next weekend. But overnight lows should be done with the freezing temperatures until Tuesday night, Wednesday morning. I think most of us will fall below freezing.